Welcome back to In Live Recaps. Today, I'm excited to show you the movie of the year titled John Wick Chapter 4. I can assure you this action-packed thriller does not disappoint. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. John Wick Chapter 4 begins with John Wick training. The Bowery King enters the scene and presents a new suit for him and asks him if he is ready.
Ready, John?
Yeah.
The scene cuts to the desert where John is chasing three horsemen. They run for their lives as he shoots them, connecting with the first one. As he continues his pursuit, the elder watches from a distance. John then takes down the second horse rider and finally the last one as well. He stops and gets off his horse while reloading as he walks towards the elder. The elder asks to what he owes this pleasure.
What do I owe the pleasure?
And John wants his ring and his freedom back. He says he no longer has the ring and tells John that the only peace he will have is in death.
And the only way John Wick will ever have freedom or peace is in death.
John doesn't care and puts two bullets into him. Upon returning to the hotel, a man known as the Harbinger enters and hands an envelope to Sharon, insisting on speaking with the manager. Sharon contacts Winston, alerting him of the situation and allowing the Harbinger to ascend to the upper floors. Harbinger then reveals that the hotel has been condemned and provides an hourglass, giving him 1 hour to evacuate. He also says that the 12 members of the High Table have signed a decree granting Marquis the power to act as judge, jury, and executioner. Winston and Sharon then make their way to have a meeting with Marquis. They enter the room and see an hourglass, as Marquis says an amazing quote.
Second chances are the refuge of men who fail.
Winston says that he shot John Wick, and Marquis laughs, saying that he's still alive and polluting everything he touches. He goes on to say that the Continental is being expelled from the filthy city of New York, and Sharon stresses the importance of everyone following the rules, even the High Table. Marquis blames Winston for Wick's actions, and as the last grains of sand fall, the Continental Hotel explodes. Winston is then declared excommunicado, and Marquis aims a gun at him but shoots Sharon instead. Karen's last words are beautiful. Kane, a blind man in Paris, overhears a young girl playing music in a small crowd. Shortly after, he is summoned to a meeting with Marquis, who wastes no time in getting to the point. Kane almost breached the terms of his deal by getting too close to his daughter that day. Despite his retirement, Marquis threatens to take Kane's daughter's life if he doesn't comply with their demand that he takes a life. Kane is given a card with the word Wick on it, which stops him in his tracks. He reveals that he was a friend of John's but is willing to provide his services to the High Table. We make our way to Japan. At the Osaka Continental Hotel, a tracker named Mr. Nobody makes his way to the reception desk. We meet Akira, who allows the dog entry as an emotional support animal. She then walks with the manager Shimazu, who is also her father. She tells him that everyone is on edge as he has a relationship with John Wick, and this could result in an unforeseeable future with the High Table. Shimazu tells her not to worry as they have done nothing wrong. He leaves her and makes his way upstairs, where he is met by John Wick. He tells him that killing the elder was a mistake. He informs him of Karen's death, and John is not pleased. He tells him that the High Table will not stop, and John refers to Shimazu as a dear friend. Downstairs, the tracker looks at John Wick in his book and quickly realizes the concierge from the High Table are in the hotel. They go to Akira and ask for the manager. Akira tells them to get comfortable as she rushes upstairs to her father and sees John Wick there. Shimazu says to stay with John as he handles the men downstairs. As he is on his way, he tells his men to get locked and loaded. They all go to arm themselves and are ready for war if necessary. He goes downstairs and greets them. They believe the hotel is providing help to John Wick. They demand full hotel access, and he agrees on the condition they hand their guns over, as no business can be conducted on continental grounds. Kane then makes his way onto the scene and greets Shimazu. They talk about their friendship, and the concierge silences them, saying the hotel is deconsecrated and to move. The lights go off and come back on very lightly, as archers surround them. They fire and kill a few men as swords are taken out. They get into a fierce combat, but the hotel wins and aims their guns at the last man standing. Simultaneously, a hit squad wearing complete bulletproof armor enters the building. They are commanded to find John Wick as the men retreat. On the rooftop, Akira and John are attacked. Akira makes marksman shots, killing some men. John knows the weak spot of the armor in the neck and expertly takes out multiple men at once. The remaining troops kill anyone inside of the hotel. Kane gets involved in the action, and for a blind man, he beats the living hell out of his assailants. Akira and John attempt to escape the building and begin killing anyone in their sights. Akira is a bloody good fighter, as she kills and massacres all the men that come her way. John takes out a few, but Akira is then shot. Her father comes to the rescue and kills the shooters. He picks his daughter up and tells John to go the way he came in. On his way, John is met by 4 assailants. He easily takes out 2 as he goes into combat with the remaining. After using a million bullets on their armor, he kills them and picks up a rifle. He is then ambushed by an NBA-sized player, and John decides to use nunchucks to fight him. He takes on 2 of them but ends up pulling his pistols out, killing them. He runs into more enemies, but the automatic takes care of them easily. He gets bored and goes back to his nunchucks. He does some sick-ass moves as he swings and kills the man. He has a 2-second breather as Kane makes his way in. John and Kane have a fight. They just pull the trigger at each other, but Kane manages to get the upper hand, and then the tracker begins firing. He shoots at Kane, and this lets John escape. The bounty for John has now been raised to 20 million US. Damn, that's a lot of money. As he goes outside, he kills another man and takes his medallion. A dog then comes from nowhere and kills 2 attackers. The tracker shows himself, and John is confused. The tracker then kills an assailant from behind and tells John they are working together now. Akira and her father are trying to escape but are found by Kane. He tells them to give John's whereabouts and leave, but Shimazu decides to protect John and takes out his sword. They begin fighting. Kane easily gets the upper hand in the fight and stabs Shimazu. Akira runs to her dying father, and Kane has mercy on her and lets her escape. John finds himself in the train station and upon boarding finds Akira there as well. She blames John for all this chaos and tells him he must kill Kane or she will. Back in New York, Winston is speaking to the Bowery King and tells him he needs to speak to John. He tells him that didn't turn well last time. We cut to a scene where the tracker is having a meeting with Marquis. He informs him that he will find and kill John for 25 million. They negotiate, and after Marquis stabs his hand, they agree on 23 million. Later on, John and Winston meet at Karen's memorial. Winston tells John that he will run out of bullets before they run out of heads. Instead, he should challenge Marquis to one-on-one combat. The members at the high table can do so, and if the challenge is presented, they must accept. Winston tells John to go and amend things with his family, who already have a place on the high table. John makes his way to Berlin and goes inside a church to his uncle's family. As he walks towards the altar, the priest pulls out a shotgun and shoots at John. He tells him, "Nice suit." As the scene switches to Marquis talking on the phone with the tracker, he informs him that John is in Berlin, and Marquis says either John dies or him. Back inside the church, John's family tortures him as they tell him that he ruined everything. They intend to kill him until he mentions the one-on-one duel. They tell John that if they kill the man who murdered their father, they will mend his ticket and he can come back to the family. He says he needs a way in, and they send Klaus to help him. They make their way to Killa Harkin, who laughs as Kane walks in. John has been set up by his family, who gave him up to save themselves. Kane and the Killa aim their guns at each other when the tracker arrives as another guest. He takes a seat as well. All 3 men want to be the one to kill John, and so they play a game of cards to decide. And as the dealer somehow draws a 5 of a kind, John slices him and everyone starts attacking each other. Shots are fired, and John makes his way inside the club, where he begins to dismantle every man coming his way. He finds the kingpin and chases him until he throws him off the stair, killing him. He takes his tooth out as evidence for killing him. He makes his way back to the church, where his family accepts him back and do an initiation for his return. Winston walks into a room where Marquis is surprised to see him. He hands him the duel notice. The terms for John's victory are his freedom, as well as Winston's title and rebuilt hotel at the high table's expense. Marquis tells him that Winston is the second, and hence he either walks away a champion or in the grave. John is immediately taken to a table where he sits opposite Marquis. They flip cards to decide the location, time, and weapon of the duel. The duel will be at sunrise with pistols, but Marquis substitutes himself for Kane. As John leaves, Kane says he won't be his second and will not fight. Marquis says if he wins, he and his daughter are freed, and the opposite holds true as well. John makes his way back to the church and meets Kane there. They have a friendly chat over their loved ones, and John speaks about Helen. Kane tells John that he is a dear friend, but if it is between him and his daughter, it has to be him. John bids him farewell and leaves. He heads down to an abandoned station where he meets the Bowery King. He hands him a suit and tells him he must look his best if he's getting married or buried. Marquis goes to his second in command, Chidi, and tells him that Wick will never make it to the duel. His man understands and goes in search of him. The contract for Wick has now changed to seek and destroy, and has been scaled to a massive $26 million US. On the radio, everyone crooked in the city is alerted to kill John Wick, as he is a thorn in their paradise. Many different crews get locked and loaded as they prepare to destroy the city to find Mr. Wick. In the station, John tells the Bowery King he needs a gun. He gives a pistol that has a 21 mag capacity and about 50 other technical benefits of the gun. John is impressed and says he needs to get as close to the church as he can. They take him on a boat ride and say that's as far as they can go. John exits, and the radio station is immediately alerted to his location. They announce it on the radio, and John simultaneously sees many men come from all directions. The fight begins, and as he takes out the first two, he is hit by a car. He takes out the driver and is rammed by another car. He deals with them and likes the idea of ramming people. He uses the car as cover while killing a few more and takes off. His location is updated on the radio, and an army of cars make their way towards him. He puts the car in reverse and kills the driver of one of them and decides to do a donut with the car as he takes care of the men in the middle. His car is then rammed and flipped over. John gets ready for war and expertly takes out four men. The fifth engages him in close combat but was quickly subdued as well. Chidi runs after John as they shoot in between cars coming their way. They go into a fist fight and he throws John onto an oncoming car. They continue fighting until he himself is thrown onto a car. John picks up his gun and goes running. It becomes chaotic as bullets are fired at will and people getting hit by cars. John tries to get off the road until he is shot at. He makes his way back into the traffic as the tracker arrives on the scene. He gets strapped and John is just running around killing anything that moves. The tracker starts firing at John as he gets away and jumps on a bike. They chase him and corner him as he does a sick-ass move. He makes his way inside a building where he can give himself the advantage. He begins eliminating his attackers one by one until he has pretty much killed everyone. The tracker then gets a call from Marquis and the tracker says $35 million for John Wick and ends the phone. He starts killing his rivals so that he can claim the prize for himself. Marquis calls him back and the tracker wants $40 million now. Marquis agrees and everyone is alerted to the prize money increase. John stays in the building and kills off two assailants as he uses a custom-made rifle. In the next 10 seconds, he takes out like 10 goons. The tracker is also shooting at will until they start fighting each other. They get into a fist fight, and John gets him at gunpoint, as Chidi is aiming his gun at the tracker's dog. Instead of saving himself, John saved the dog and the tracker immediately realizes that John is one honorable man. John runs out of the building and looks at his watch. It is near sunrise, but his location is announced once again. He has a good stare down with his attackers until he starts spamming his trigger. Like a game with levels, he has to take out a few men every flight of stairs he climbs. He kills and kills and kills some more until he reaches the top. He is then thrown down the first flight of stairs until he is beaten and kicked down to the bottom of all the stairs. There are 3 minutes to go and as he gives up, Kane gets there and tells him to start climbing. He helps him up and they start fighting their way to the top. Kane and John are one deadly combo as they easily take out many assailants making their way to the top. Chidi is once again fighting with John. But this time he has had enough and gets John onto the ground. He walks towards him with his pistol. And as John is about to die, the tracker arrives and looks at his dog and decides to save John's life and shoot the assailant. Kane makes his way down and stabs the man's hand with a pencil, subduing him. As Kane and John walk off, the tracker looks at the man that hurt his puppy and attacks him. He kills him and his dog pees on his head for payback. John just makes it in time for sunrise as the tracker takes a seat to enjoy the show. The two men take off their vests. They are handed a pistol each and are ordered to take their positions. Kane tells him, "See you in the next life." They take 30 paces away from each other and are handed a bullet. Kane tells Marquis to shut the F up. Winston and John enjoy the sunrise. John asks for Winston's last words and he tells him to have fun out there. The Harbinger asks if both men are ready. When they agree, he says, "Fire!" Kane is hit in the shoulder, and that's it. They come closer to each other and reload their pistols. He says, "Fire!" again. John cops one in the shoulder, and Kane gets it in the stomach area. They are commanded to step closer. They reload once again, and some sad music is being played knowing that one must die. Everyone just stops and stares at each other, awaiting the call. John is on the ground bleeding out as Winston looks at him in concern. The tracker gets emotional as well. Marquis grabs the last bullet and walks to Kane to take his gun. Kane asks if his daughter is free, and he says yes. He loads the bullet in the gun and walks up to John and aims it at him. Winston interjects and calls him arrogant and says John didn't shoot. He looks at him, but John pulls the trigger and gets a headshot. The tracker laughs in happiness, and the Harbinger checks on Marquis. He tells John his obligation is satisfied and he is free to do as he pleases. He tells Kane that he and his daughter are also free. He tells Winston that he will be reinstated and the hotel will be rebuilt. Their business is concluded and they walk off. Kane goes to John and calls him brother, and John says that Kane owes him one, insinuating that he intentionally didn't kill Kane. Winston and John speak, and John tells him, "Will you take me home?" Winston looks at his wound and says, "Of course." Winston's eyes become watery as John sits alone on the stairs. He thinks of Helen and whispers that word. He slowly collapses on the ground. Not gonna lie, this almost had me in tears. Back at home, we are at the graveyard with John and Helen's graves right next to one another. The Bowery King, Winston, and John's dogs stand there. Winston is shattered and puts his hand on the tombstone and says, "Goodbye, my son." They walk off, and sadly, the movie comes to an end. We have a post-credits scene, which is just as sad. Kane has a bouquet of flowers and is finally walking towards his daughter with a smile on his face. But we find Akira walking towards him and pulls a knife out as the movie cuts to black. Do you think this is the end of John Wick? Comment down below. Check out these other videos and make sure to subscribe and tap the bell to be notified about our latest videos, and leave a like and comment to help the channel out. Thank you for watching. See you next time.